The things we should give thanks for. What should you thank God for? Thank God for life. Talk about protection of life, especially in Nigeria, where the causes of death, the forces of death, are more in number than elsewhere. In Nigeria, the things that can easily kill you, they are all over the place. They are very plentiful. So that you are still alive like this in Nigeria, you should be giving thanks to God, though. Because the things that can kill you, the things that have killed many people, millions, hundreds of thousands, they are sitting and they seem to be increasing. If it is not a bad road, it can be a reckless driver. If it's not a reckless driver, it can be a dubious spare part seller who will carry expired brake pad or inferior brake pad and tell you, "Oga, this is original, made in Germany." And then you will pay money for it, and then you are cruising in your car, driving at 120, 140 with flavor playing, Nabania. And you are confident that you have a good brake system. Only for you, for something to happen, you match brake. You don't know that it's bicycle brake equivalent that is in your car. You know how many people have died out of that? If you escape all these ones, what of armed robbers, bandits, Boko Haram, terrorists, killer herdsmen? If you escape those ones, diseases, sicknesses. Haven't you heard of somebody who they say, "No, he just headache, he just complained of headache," and, "Oh no, he just complained of stomach ache." But you and I know you have suffered stomach ache for like 3, 4, 5 days and you're still alive. Even common malaria that have been eradicated in some countries for years is still killing people in Nigeria. But you have this, you survive. Or if these ones do not kill you, what about quack doctors? Quack doctors that can even do surgery in you and forget their scissors inside your stomach. You know how many people have been torn open like 2, 3 times? And in Nigeria, there is no lawsuit. Two guys were lying on the hospital bed, and after surgery, the other one was very happy. He said, "Thank God, this surgery was okay." Then the other guy asked him, "Who operated it?" He mentioned the name of the doctor. He said, "Bros, if I were you, don't rejoice here too." He said, "That doctor, he's fond of forgetting things inside people's stomach." As they were talking, the doctor came inside and asked them, "I beg, I'm looking for my face cap. Has anybody seen?" Of fake drug dealers, those who go to China or any place to manufacture low standard drugs. Do you know how many people have been killed in Nigeria? It's not one of the things that you wanted to use and kill Dora Akunyele. Fake drugs. It can complicate your... In fact, even if you are alive, it can make your life... your life would be like a car that you were given to a quack mechanic. It will never be the same again. If you escape all those ones, PDP is there to kill you. If you escape PDP, APC is there. You escape APC, Nigerian police is there. It's fake Nigerian police. NEPA is there. SAS. What will kill you in Nigeria about? Then the Oga Pata Pata of all of them, witches and wizards. But don't get carried away. Which witches and wizards I'm talking about? It's not those ones that they say they fly at night and with broom. Nah, those ones are not your problems. The witches and wizards, they tell you travel at night or come in form of bats or owl. Those ones are not your problem. In Luke chapter 9, Jesus, the Bible says Jesus gave them authority and power over all the devil. That means the Oga Pata Pata of all the devils and all his what? Followers. The witches and wizards in Nigeria, they are small devils. God has given you authority and power over the big one. How much that one? And in Mark chapter 16, say, "Nothing shall hurt you. You shall not be hurt." The witches and wizards I'm talking about, they are in the presidency, in the National Assembly, in the Senate, in government houses. They are civil servants. They are politicians. They are Hausas, Igbos, Yorubas. They are Catholics, Pentecostals, Protestants, Christians, Muslims. Those are the witches and wizards that kill more people in Nigeria. In fact, the other witches, I don't even know whether they have killed anybody. But these particular witches or wizards I'm talking about, they are responsible for thousands of deaths. If you are giving money to do road, and you don't do the road, and somebody has accident because of bad road and die, what do you think you are? You are a witch. You have taken blood. You are giving money to equip hospitals. You refuse to build a hospital or even equip. And the medication or medical attention that would have saved somebody is not there, and the person dies. What do you think you are? It's a witch. We have them all over the place. That in Nigeria, pensioners will be queuing to take their pension of 50,000. And they wait and wait until some will die. Because somebody doesn't want to push they are fine. Or somebody has swallowed the money meant for their pension. And you tell me you are a human being. No, you are a winch. Witch is sweet. You are a winch. Winch. And a huge one, a winch. Those are the ones you should be afraid of. Forget about these ones that some men of God tell you that. Those are not the ones. The witches and wizards that have key destinies in Nigeria, they are presidents, governors, senators, members of House of Rep, civil servants, and contractors. Those are the ones that have key. All these deliverance you are running about for people to release your destiny. Those who are holding your destiny, they are in Asoroku. I am very serious about it. It's not the small witches, they say they are flying up and down. Those ones, they are looking for blood. If they don't see your blood, they will go and chop fruit and rest. You survive this kind of people in Nigeria, you should be happy. There's another set of witches or wizards, though. Fake pastors and men of God. Those ones who have given people wrong pseudo-religious theories. They have destroyed marriages, bankrupted businesses, and made people to start thinking backward. They even block you from seeing where your real problem is coming. Men of God are coming to a family and brother will become afraid of his own brother. Relatives will no longer eat their food. Before you even shake a relative, you remember what they told you, that they are transferring power. If you have survived all these forces, just know that Psalm 91 is working in your life. He said, a thousand may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right. You, it will never approach, because his faithfulness is buckler and shield. He said, your eyes have only to look to see how the wicked are repaid. He has given his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. It can also be Psalm 125. Those who put their trust in the Lord, they are like Mount Zion that cannot be shaken, that stands firm forever. And as the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people. Help me tell somebody, God has surrounded you. God has surrounded you. That is the reason you are alive today. And I pray that he'll continue to surround you all the days of your life. Amen. In Nigeria, our average life expectancy is very low. What is keeping us alive aren't things you see physically. It's by the grace of God. That's why you should wake up and be thankful. In Nigeria especially, be thankful. So thank God for protection.
Sign up with the largest community of Catholics online. Meet new friends, chat, post pictures and videos, make and receive audios and video calls, interact with lots of priests and religions. Download the app from Google Play Store.